Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this marketing guide, you're going to learn what the heck a landing page is and how to use it to generate more leads for your business. When you stick around to the end, I'll actually be walking you through a proven copywriting formula for your headlines and bullet points so that your landing page starts converting the first time you run traffic. Make sure you check out the timestamp table of contents in the description, skip around this video along with some other helpful links to landing page softwares and full-blown sales funnel tutorials. So before we dive into how to put together a landing page, what software to use, what it looks like, the whole lead generation process, let's just start with what the heck is a landing page? Because there seems to be quite a bit of confusion on this. Now, simply all a landing page is one page on your site that has one goal, which is to collect contact information. You get that contact information by exchanging something of value, which is called a lead magnet or an opt-in offer, opt-in gift, whatever you want to call it, tripwire offer. We'll talk about that more later in this tutorial video. But what the key difference between a landing page and everything else on your site is that there are no links. So if you're taking a look at this example you see here, this landing page is almost perfect, but you see at the top, there are links to the homepage, the blog, and the contact. You don't want any of that on the landing page. We want people to only be able to do one thing when they hit our website, and that is enter their contact information so that we can follow up with them to eventually get them to purchase our product or service. So now that we know what the heck a landing page is, let's go ahead and take a deeper dive into the different elements of a landing page, and then we'll talk about how it integrates with your overall lead generation process. Now, the first step to putting together your landing page is deciding what contact information you actually need. Now, as a general rule of thumb, the more things you ask for, the less likely people are to enter their contact information. It's just kind of how it works. So if you want to maximize the number of people that enter their contact information in your landing page, then ask for as little as possible. So name and email, or just email, is really all you need to get started. And then if you want to start asking about their company address, company size, you know, and the type of business that they have, it's going to dramatically lower your opt-in rates. That is the percentage of people who enter their contact information. So this is just an example of what you could ask for on a landing page, but in green here, you see this is really all you need to ask for. Orange is kind of like, yeah, if you're getting a lot of leads or you really need to know this information. And red, you only want to do this if you have so many leads, you have no idea what to do with them. And you just want to filter people out. You only want the people who are really, really interested in what you have to offer. So once you've decided how much information you actually need to collect, again, less is more in this instance, let's go ahead and talk about the different elements of your landing page, starting with your headline. And all your headline needs to do is answer the question, is this for me and what's in it for me? You see, the key success factor to a headline is making sure that it's all about your prospect, your ideal customer, not about your product, service, or whatever you're offering as a lead magnet. Again, when you stick around to the end, I'll be walking you through a copywriting formula so you can write the right types of headlines and the right types of bullets. Now, the next thing we want to talk about is your call to action. And your call to action is simply a button that they click to enter their contact information. So typically it'll be download now, book a call now, you know, get your free whatever now. They'll go ahead and click that button, and then a pop-up will appear where they can enter their contact information. Now, what's very important is this is the only link that should be on the page and it should stand out. This doesn't mean it needs to be bright red or bright orange. It can still flow with whatever the design of the page is, but it just needs to be clear that this is what they click in order to get whatever you're talking about. Now, the next part of your landing page is going to be the bullet points. And all the bullet points need to do is answer the question, what does it do for me? So bullet points are all about benefits, not necessarily features. So benefits are the results that people are going to be able to enjoy as a result of getting whatever you're offering on your landing page. Again, we'll get to lead magnets in a moment here. So it's just very important that you're always focused on the visitor, not necessarily talking about how awesome you are. Now, the next part of our landing page is our proof. And of course, this only works if you actually have proof. Not all of us have testimonials or have been on media websites. But something you'll notice is when you go to a new website, especially if it's an influencer, they'll have all of those little logos at the bottom of all the media publications they've shown up on. Or if you scroll down the page, you'll see that there are testimonials. And these just serve as a way to show that you are a real person and they're not going to be dumb for giving you their contact information, because nobody wants to feel like they've been scammed. Nobody wants to feel like they've been stupid. So we need to show that you're a real person, you're a real business, and you're here to actually help them and not just spam their inbox with stuff. So here are two live examples of some of the first landing pages I ever put together, and it kind of shows you what is possible. You can see here both have a headline. The one, of course, on the left is a bad example, and that's why I included it, because you can barely read the headline. You really need the headline to be clear and easy to read, and you can see the simple three-step funnel to grow your audience and business from scratch is very clear, very easy to read, whereas the other headline, how to be instantly recognized as a credible expert and authority in any niche from scratch, not only is that hard to read, that is just way too long. It's like a run-on sentence, so we want to be short and concise. Now, moving down these two landing pages, you'll notice that they both have bullet points, and they both have a section that talks about the host. And the main difference here is one of the landing pages actually has some testimonials from the webinar and product and service that was being offered here, where the other one doesn't. And this is something that we'll get to in step number five when we talk about split testing, whether or not you actually need this. But if you're brand new to a market, the more social proof you can have on your page in terms of just showing that, hey, other real people have found this helpful, is very important and will help with boosting your conversion rates. That is the number of people that enter their contact information on their landing page. Now, that is the quick overview of what the heck a landing page is, all the different elements you need on the landing page, and how to put them together. And the two landing pages I just showed you, the first one was built on Thrive Themes, which is WordPress, which is my favorite software solution. Then, of course, there's also ClickFunnels, which is what the second one was built on. And you also have things like Lead Pages and Kartra and Instapage, and a plethora of other ones. Even MailChimp does it now for free. So there's a link in the description to a full-on video review that goes through all of your landing page design or software options and how to choose the best one for you. So now that we are pretty much good to go with our landing page, let's go ahead and talk about the overall lead generation process. Like, why the heck do we need a landing page? Like, how does it work in terms of the greater scheme of things? So go ahead and take a look at this diagram. It is a complete overview of the entire process of taking someone who has no idea who you are all the way to customer. And you'll notice at the very end of audience is where our landing page shows up, and that's where we're going to focus. The whole purpose of our landing page is to transform an audience member into a lead. Once we have their contact information, they are now a lead. So if we zoom in here, you'll see that we'll be using ads and content to drive traffic to this landing page. And once they enter their name and email, they'll not only get the lead magnet, but they'll be put into an email sequence that eventually pushes them over to a sales page. And this next diagram shows us how the landing page fits into our process. So whenever we're driving traffic via ads or content, we want people to go to our landing page, and then they'll be able to get something called a lead magnet. So this is the lead generation process. We run ads, we send them to our landing page, and they enter their contact information for the lead magnet. So now let's talk about what the heck a lead magnet is, because a lead magnet is what allows the landing page to work. Otherwise, you just have a page and you say, give me your contact information and I'm going to give you nothing in return, right? We need to be able to justify why we're asking for contact information, and that's where the lead magnet comes in. Now, there are tons of different lead magnet options. I'm going to go through two basic ones. You can get as complicated as a launch sequence or a webinar or a full-on video sales letter. Here, we're just going to talk about providing a guide, blueprint, or case study, or a free consultation call. In both instances, you want to be asking the question, what do I need to give them in order for them to make a buying decision? So think of your lead magnet as a pre-sales materials, right? This is something that's going to be helpful in terms of educating them and helping them solve a problem that they already have. So it can't just be like, here's how great my product and service is, right? That's just marketing materials. That's not helpful. But if we have a lead magnet that actually provides value in and of itself, that's actually going to help us with the sales process. And so that could be a PDF, an audio, a video, a diagram, or it could be a consultation call, right? Where you get on the phone and you just answer their 21 questions, right? And you use a sales script to lead them through seeing the value in whatever your service is. So here's a quick rundown of the software you can use to put all this together. If you're doing a diagram or PDF, you can use a free tool called Canva. Of course, linked in the description to how to put together a lead magnet using Canva. And then if you want to do a video, a sales letter, or a webinar, you can go ahead and use Camtasia or ScreenFlow to record your screen. And I recommend using Vimeo to upload your sales videos, not YouTube. But if you're on a budget, YouTube Unlisted works as well. Now, if you're going to be fancy and put together some sort of free calculator or tool in the form of a spreadsheet or a Google Doc, you can actually go over to Fiverr and find someone for just $50 to $100 to put that together for you. It's a great way to differentiate your lead magnet because most people just do a PDF or a webinar. And of course, finally, if you're doing anything in terms of an audio, Audacity is a free tool that allows you to edit your audio. And if you want to put together a written lead magnet that's actually on a site, I recommend using WordPress and Thrive Themes. So if you want to learn more about putting together a lead magnet, you need some more lead magnet ideas, there's a playlist link in the description that will walk you through a ton of different options. We're just scratching the surface here. So now that we've justified why people enter their name and email on our landing page, it's time to talk about the follow-up, because really the power of our landing page is getting people to enter their contact information. And of course, if we don't do anything with that contact information, then the landing page, well, it's useless. Why would we have a landing page, right? So here's what you can do with that contact information. If you are in a sales process where you need to get on the phone with them, then you want a 3 to 5 email sequence to get them to book a call. And what's also really important is if your lead magnet was a strategy call with you, you want an automated process for following up with people, because I can tell you from personal experience, it stinks sitting down at your desk thinking that you have 5 sales calls and only one person shows up. Right? That's not a great place to be. It just wreaks havoc on your schedule and also your self-esteem, right? Because people just aren't showing up. So you want a sequence to ensure that people actually are reminded, and if they can't make the sales call time, they actually reschedule so it doesn't waste a bunch of your time. I recommend using a calendar app like Calendly or Book Like a Boss. Now, when it comes to everything else, if you're not doing a strategy call, then this email sequence has you covered. So the very first email in the sequence is essentially, hey, here's your free stuff. And then you list 3 to 4 bullet points as to why it's so awesome and how it will help them achieve the result that they're looking for. So if we think of our product and services solving big problem number 2, we want to solve little problem number 1, A, B, C, D. So we want to essentially deliver value before we say, hey, you should pay us to solve this huge problem over here that our product or service does. And so that's what this email sequence is designed to do. Say, hey, this lead magnet is super valuable and helpful, and here's why. And by the way, if you like this lead magnet, you should check out our product or service. It solves all of your other problems, right? Well, probably not all of them, but a large majority, right? So our second email is going to harp on the big challenge that they face. You talk about how hard it can be to achieve the results that they're looking for, and you can debunk some common myths. And this email in the PS section is where you're going to introduce your paid offer. So you can be driving them to a video sales letter, you could just be driving them to a shopping cart, or you could be driving them to a written sales letter, however you like. Now, with the third email, which goes out on day 3 or 4, it'll just be a hero story, a testimonial of someone who's been successful going through your product or service. If you don't have a testimonial, you can do a hypothetical. Just make sure that it's very clear that it's a hypothetical situation and you're not just making it up. Now, the final two emails in the sequence, 4 and 5, are just going to be all about how great their life would be as a result of purchasing this product or service. So here it's kind of like the red zone. You're just trying to sell, and if they don't, then you'll have to drop them into another email sequence where you'll eventually follow up with them later on. Of course, that's outside the scope of our lead generation funnel. If we can't get them to take action in 5 emails, which is essentially 7 days from them entering their name and email on our landing page, then we need to back off from being salesy and try a different strategy. So link in the description to a video that walks you through a content marketing plan that you can use in conjunction with an email sequence to follow up with people who don't buy your product or service. Now, once we have our emails, we are complete with the lead generation process. If you want to learn more about how to actually write a sales letter and write sales copy, for $13 on Amazon, you can get The Ultimate Sales Letter by Dan Kennedy. You can skip all those fancy copywriting courses and just buy this book. It's like 13 or 15 bucks, and it will give you everything you need to write decent sales copy. Writing sales copy and learning how to master it is going to take a lifetime. Now, the last step here is split testing your landing page. So at this point, we've got people's contact information, we've created a lead magnet that gets people to enter their contact information, and we've come up with a simple email sequence to follow up with them to get them to purchase our product or service. Now we want to make sure that we are constantly improving our landing page so we get more people to go through this process. And that's where something called split testing comes in. So essentially all we do is we have landing page A and we have landing page B, and then we test back and forth to see which one performs best. So all we do is change out the headline, or we change out a couple bullet points, or we change out what the lead magnet is. You want to make big changes. I'll get to more on that in a second, to see which one gets people to enter their contact information more. Now, as you run traffic and you split it, most landing page softwares will allow you to do this, you'll find that landing page A or B actually gets you more leads. So what do you wanna do? You wanna figure out, okay, let's try more pages like landing page A. Now, what's very important here with your split testing is you want big, and I mean big differences. Don't test like one or two words in your headline. You want completely different headlines. So imagine, for example, your ideal landing page is here, right in the center. Well, if you try variation A and then variation A1, you're going to make a lot of micro adjustments until you get here. Whereas you try variation A and variation B, then let's say B doesn't work, right? Well, then you'll try and test version C. And then let's say version C does better. And so now you'll test version D. And so when you have these bigger tests, I know this is a little nebulous, but when you have these bigger tests, it actually allows you to much more quickly get to the center and find that ideal landing page messaging and design that's going to perform the best. And so that's all there is to it, to what the heck a landing page is, how to set it up, and your entire lead generation process. Now, if you're still watching this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Make sure you comment below with any questions you have on your landing pages, because now is time for the bonus, where we're going to go through the actual copywriting formula. How the heck do we write our headlines, and how the heck do we write our bullet points? So this is a very simple process. It doesn't have to be complicated. Here's what you have to do. You start by answering two questions. So question number one, what results are they after? Question number two, what is their perceived roadblock? So we'll use a case study for this, someone who's trying to grow a YouTube channel. So what results are they after? They want to be full-time on YouTube, wake up and make videos on their own schedule. Sounds like a pretty cool life, right? So what's getting in the way of them achieving that big result? Well, they need more views, they need to get more subscribers, improve their video quality, and rank for important keywords. So these are all things that they could believe that are getting in the way of them achieving the result of a faster channel growth. So now all we need to do is take these results and take these roadblocks and add them into a copywriting formula, so it's very easy for us to pump out headlines and bullet points. So here are the two. We have how to result without hard part, and how to result even if roadblock. So I'll just read a couple. You can pause the video if you want to read through all these examples. But the first, we have how to grow your channel, which is a result that they want, without getting lots of views, a perceived roadblock or problem that they have. Skipping down a couple, how to get more views without having a lot of subscribers. And you can see here, we are just using this formula and swapping out different results, roadblocks, and problems. And as we go through our split testing, we'll figure out which one works. So you want to come up with as many as possible and then choose two that you're actually going to move forward with for your first split test. So in this particular example, I'm going to do how to grow your channel without getting lots of views, and how to rank videos even if you have a small channel channel. Now, even though I've chosen to start with these two, it's important that you remember that split testing is going to be something that goes on and on and on. So you really do want to have a lot of different options and a lot of different headlines that you can test in the future. Now, when it comes to your bullet points, you can actually use the exact same formula. All you have to do is chop off that how-to. So going back to our original list here, number two, we see how to grow your channel even if your video quality stinks. Well, if we remove how-to and just have the bullet grow your channel even if you think your video quality stinks, or get more views without having a lot of subscribers, those two sentences without the how-to in the beginning are all you need for your bullet points. So at this point, you know how to write your headlines and you know how to write your bullet points. Of course, you can modify the way your bullet points are written, but this is just a quick and dirty way to have decent sales copy on your landing page ready to go. So thank you so much for watching. I sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. If you did, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more in-depth marketing tactics and strategies just like the ones covered in this video. Comment below if you have any questions on your landing pages or lead generation process. Make sure you check out those links in the description because they will walk you through everything else you need to know to get set up with your lead generation funnel. And until the next video, keep building the business you love.